Hello guys, today we will discuss about the subspace. What is subspace? Suppose V is a vector space, then subspace is actually subset of vector space V with W having some property. So let's go through by a formal definition. Suppose W is a subset of a vector space V over the V is vector space over R. We call W is a subspace of V if W is also a vector space over R. This vector space form over some operation, and that operation will be same whatever the operation on V is there. Now we know that what is subset. So subset is, suppose V is a set, then some collection of element of V, if you take that, then if we form a set of those elements, then we will say that set is actually a subset of V. And what is vector space? So we know that suppose V is a set and we define two operation, addition and scalar multiplication on V. With this addition and scalar multiplication having close property, suppose X and Y belongs to V, then if you add them, and if this should be belongs to V, and this scalar multiplication, so suppose C is a real number and X is an element of V, and this X C times V also should belongs to V. If suppose these properties followed in V, and with, as we have seen in video lecture, there are 8 properties which we use to say axioms. If those properties followed by this operation, then we will say V is a vector space. Now suppose W is a subset of V, and if we define the same operation, addition and scalar multiplication with the property same, like this, X belongs to W and Y belongs to W, and to making a subspace to be a subspace of V, it should be X plus Y also belongs to W. And suppose C is a real number and X belongs to W, then CX should also belongs to W. This is closed under addition, and this is closed, and this is called closed under scalar multiplication. With same properties, this 8 properties which V follows, if W will also follow, then we will say W is a subspace of V. Now, suppose W is a given subset of V, then how we will check that W is also a subspace? W is a subset of V, it will be given. Then how we will check that W is subspace of V? Then there is 3 criteria. If W will satisfy that, then we will say W is subspace of V. Those 3 criteria are, 0 should be belongs to W, and the second criteria is, if X, suppose X an element belongs to W, Y is an element of W, then addition should also belongs to W. This is also called closed under addition. And the third criteria is, suppose C is a real number and X is an element of W, then their multiplication, which is called a scalar multiplication, and if that multiplication is also element of W, which is called a closed under scalar multiplication, then if these criteria followed by W, then we will say W is a subspace of V. Now let's do some example. The given vector space is R2 over R, and we have given a subset W. W is XY coordinate, and if we add X plus Y, it will become 0, and XY element of R, these 2 condition. So W is a subset given of R2. We need to check W is a subspace or not. So let's do our first criteria, that 0 should belongs to W. So if we take X is equal to 0 and Y is equal to 0, and if we add them, 0 plus 0, it becomes 0. It means 0 0 belongs to W. That means zero element of R2, which is also belongs to W. Now we need to check the second criteria. The second criteria is let W1 is one element is X1, Y1, and the second W2, second element is X2, Y2. Now if we add them, W1 plus W2, so it will become X1, Y1 plus X2, Y2. This is equal to coordinate Y addition will happen, same operation as we did in R2. So this will become X1 plus X2, comma Y1 plus Y2. Now W1 is element of W, W2 is element of W. It means these two will satisfy this condition, means X1 plus Y1 is equal to 0, and this this is the for W1. And for W2, X2 plus Y2 is equal to 0. So these two conditions we have given because W1 and W2 are element of W. So now what we did in addition of W1 plus W2, we got these coordinates X1 plus X2 comma Y1 plus Y2. So let's check, is this addition is belongs to W. So we need to we add them plus Y1 plus Y2. We added them, and as we said these are the element of R2, so that swapping can we do easily. So we can write X1 plus Y1 plus X2 plus Y2, and this is 0, and this is 0 as W1, this is 0 as W1 is that coordinate addition is become 0 as given condition, and this is 0. So 0 plus 0 becomes 0. It means this addition is belongs to W. So second criteria is followed. Now we need to check third criteria. The third criteria is a real number C, and suppose W1 is equal to X1, Y1, an element of W, and so W1 is element of a W. It means X1 plus Y1 is equal to 0. Now let's do multiplication. C into W1 is equal to, it will become coordinate wise multiplication will happen, same operation in R, as in R2. So it will become C X1 comma C Y1. Now we need to check these coordinates make some zero or not. Then we will say this scalar multiplication is in W happened, that is closed under scalar multiplication. So let's do the sum. So sum X1 plus C Y1, this we can write X1 plus Y1. We are able to do this because as we can able to do in R2, so we can do this. And we have given, and this is 0, it means this is 0. It means C times W1 is element of W. So all three criteria done by W, it means W is a subspace of R2. So let's see it geometrically. What we mean by a subspace? So this is the a vector space R2 representing this plane is actually XY plane. R2 means XY plane. Now we have given a subset W which is coordinate XY and having some condition X plus Y is equal to 0. If we see it as a in XY plane, so actually X, this W represent a line which pass through origin with having slope minus 1. So actually W is this line which pass through origin. And if we see clearly the first condition 0, it passes through origin. So 0 element is here, is present in W. And if we do addition with any two element, then it will be the same in the line. And again, and the third criteria is by taking any real number, if you multiply with this any element of W, then it will be again in the line. So it means W is a subspace of R2. Now suppose another W1 is a subspace of R2, and which having condition the same coordinates with changing the slope actually. So subspace of R2 will be the passing represent the line which pass through origin. Why this is pass through origin? Because of the first criteria, zero element should be in W.
So any subspace of R2 other than trivial subspaces which are zero subspace and R2 itself represent a line which pass through origin.
Now we will see a subset of R2 which will not form a subspace. It means we have to check those three criteria which we discussed earlier, and we will see that which conditions will not followed by this W1. So and the let's check this, the first criteria, that zero element in W1. So first see clearly W1 is actually this subset of R2 with the same condition as we discussed earlier, x plus y is equal to 0, but that x is, that x and y belong taken from this integer, that means x, y are integer. So we know that 0 belongs to z, so we can take the coordinate 0, 0, and this is follow the condition 0 plus 0 which is 0. So it means 0 element is in W. So first criteria satisfied W1. Now we need to check second criteria. The second criteria is we will take two element from W1. Let's take x1, y1, and second element is x2, y2. So if we from W1, if we add them, this will become coordinate y addition.
And addition of two integer is integer.
Also previously we have seen that addition of coordinates, that is x1 plus x2 plus y1 plus y2 is equal to 0. Here same thing will also happen. So conditions of W1 are satisfied. It means it follow the addition close. This W1 is closed under addition. So it means this is belongs to W1. So second criteria followed by W1. Now the third criteria is any real number multiplied with an element, which is a scalar multiplication, and this is lacking W1. So let's take any real number we can take. So let's take any 1 by 2. This is a rational number, and element of W1 which is we can take 1 and minus 1. So this is from W1 satisfying this condition, and also these are the integer. So this is the element of W1. Now if we multiply them, so this will be a coordinate wise multiplication, so this will become 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. Now here is the missing part, that this is not an integer, this is not an integer. It means W1 is not closed under scalar multiplication. So here the third condition is lacking for W1. So the W1 is a subset but not a subspace.